countdown for the timer.
Yep. All right. 3, 2, 1, go. All right. So the first stage is Battle of Hoth, split up into four stages. First one, we just got to kill these four probe droids. Nice and easy. Second stage, we'll have, I think it's two AT-STs and two probe droids. Now on the next stage, we're going to have two AT-STs, two probe droids, and an AT-AT. And 100% you'd use the tow cable to beat the AT-AT, but it's quicker just to shoot it. Took the wrong route on the first AT-ST, so lost a bit of time there. I don't know how that guy didn't die doing that. Alright. Just one more stage in this first level. Where we get four AT-STs. Two AT-ATs and four probe droids. Oh, I wasn't meant to die there. But lives don't really matter in this game, because once you get to the next stage, you should get full lives again. Alright, that's the first level gun. The second level will be on foot. So it's much easier to control. No real tricks in this level, just gotta go as fast as possible. And I also haven't practiced as much as I would have liked to. So forgive me if I'm bad at this. Just getting some seekers, which are basically missiles, to use on boss a bit later on. First part of the level complete. We're going to be cutting these corners here, so hopefully I don't die in the process. Three corners can be pretty tricky to cut, but once you practice it enough, it's pretty alright. All we're coming up to the first boss of the run, which is an AT-ST. I'm only going to use laser to shoot him, because I want to save those seekers for later on when we fight IG-88 and Boba Fett. Oh, he killed me. Yeah, my health was a bit low going into that, but that's fine. I'll just get him there. Last room, just gotta clear out the two stormtroopers inside the ship. The ones outside don't really matter. I'll just activate the door. Now the next level is the asteroid field. So not much going on in this level, just gotta kill a bunch of TIE fighters and TIE bombers. Very bad at the vehicle levels in this game. Very tricky to hard, very tricky to aim on the Hori controller. If you have any donations, you can go ahead and read. TIE fighters, and now we just got the TIE bombers to finish off. That's it for this level. Yeah, you gotta do it anytime in this next level. This next level is an auto-scroller, so the reason most people don't play this game. Go ahead.
We have a couple of donations. Louis Costello gave $4.75, saying Uru. And Mash gave $10, saying Stanimal, what a boss.
This level, just gotta jump over these things at the start, make sure you jump onto the right trains. And avoid jumping when there's a sharp corner, because you'll fall off. One thing is you can look up for most of the level to, I think it's meant to save around 3 seconds, but it's very boring just staring at that, so I won't bother with that today. I don't need the extra lives, I'm just picking them up for fun. little scary. You don't want to die on this level. Puts you too far back. So we're coming up on the end of the level now. Gotta jump onto the next train, then we get to fight the boss, which is IG-88. Cooperates, we'll be able to just shoot 10 seekers at him and that will kill him, but sometimes he just decides to run away for no reason, so we'll see what happens. It usually doesn't cost too much time. So I'm just gonna try and shoot him, and he went that way, which is very weird. He might kill me here, unless I can get him. I think I killed him the same time he killed me. But that still finishes the level. Alright, now this next level is my favourite. It's Gulf Spaceport, where you get to fight Boba Fett. It's also the longest on foot level. I'm just gonna grab these seekers at the start. This level, in about 2 minutes, we're gonna get the jetpack, which lets us do some really fun glitches. Well, I guess one really fun glitch. Level is also very slidey, so I'm basically constantly holding strafe to avoid sliding off the edge. I had a really bad angle on that jump. That's fine though. Only a small time loss. Not gonna do it again though. Too much health going into this. This is a quicker way to die, so I can walk back to the door. These doors are open. Up on the jetpack, and straight away I'm gonna do the glitch. Normally you just hover across this next canyon and land on the pillars and let your jetpack recharge, but I'm gonna use the glitch that lets us fly up into the air really high and just hover straight across. There we go. Had a bit of a bad angle, so I'm just trying to adjust it a little bit. We'll see what happens. Too bad. So if you get this glitch right, it saves about 15 seconds all up. I'm just gonna do another little one just to cover that last distance. Yeah, that's just the first part of the level. Normal playthrough, you'd be coming up to the AT-ST room now, where you get to fight the AT-ST again. But we're gonna skip the rest of the level and go straight to the boss fight. There is a way to clip straight through the floor, but normally you have to go right over the wall to get in here. And I'm going to try and do a little glitch here where I go over the elevator now and it's rising up, which when it gets to the top it starts the cutscene. I'm going to, if I die at the right time... Nah. So normally I'd get some other weird camera angle here, where it lets me skip Boba Fett and just lets his ship fly up through the floor so I can just beat that and finish the level, but we're gonna have to fight Boba Fett here anyway. And I'm dead at the moment, I have to just wait to respawn. And Boba Fett's just gonna fly away. And that would just finish his ship off with the pulse cannon. A really bad time for this level. Next level is the speeder bike level. Gonna be using a glitch here where we just kill that first guy. And we can only stay ahead of the second guy. We can't get ahead of the rest. But we're gonna use a glitch that stops every other rider. So I just have to stay ahead until that point of the level. Alright, so here we turn this way, and that makes every other rider stop. I'm not exactly sure how it works, but you kill the first guy, stay ahead of the second guy, turn left instead of right at that area, and it stops every other rider. Yeah, this area is very tricky. It just wants to crash you every corner. And I'm also bad at any level in a vehicle. At least I didn't die in that last bit. It's pretty tricky. Sometimes there's a part coming up later where we have to open some doors and jump on some boxes. Right, if I line it up right, I can go straight through the door. Which I didn't line it up right. At least I got that. Backup health. Okay. right now. I'll probably take a death in this next room because there's a lot of enemies and they'll probably kill me anyway. But almost got the second switch. Game's not going to let me stay on the box. Okay, that's all good. So I accidentally used pulse cannon before. I meant to use it on this boss. I'm not sure if I have enough to finish him with it, but it'll do a lot of damage. That's fine. Alright, that's the end of this level. Now we got the sewers of Imperial City. Just gotta... Now this level can be pretty long, but we're gonna use another jetpack clip that lets us get to a key card early. It's a little bit weird being out of bounds. Dan doesn't like it very much. But we got it. Now once we grab that, this opens up for us, so it makes it easy. I'm just gonna get an extra weapon pack. Normally, we'd skip the boss on this level. I'm still gonna try and skip the boss, but if it doesn't work, then we want the disruptor pack. Thank you. Alright, so this is the boss area coming up, but we're going to see if we can skip it. Yep. Just going to have to do that again. But I have skipped the boss. Just got to clip out of here. And go in there. That's the end of that level. Now we've got Zyza's palace coming up. He's the main bad guy of the whole game. It's also a very dark level. Gonna try another little skip here. I'm not sure how much time it saves, but it avoids you activating a switch and opening a door. This isn't going to give it to me. Oh, I'll just go in and hit the switch. It's a bit safer. The first part of this level. Coming up on the final boss. There's one more level after this, but no more bosses. That's what all these disruptors are for. Now I don't have a little dot on my screen, so it's gonna be tricky to aim, but it should be fine. We've got two spare disruptors, so we'll probably miss all of them. Thank you. so that's the final boss of the game. Now I've just got a bit of an auto-scroller before we get to the big Skyhook space station. Killing enemies here is optional, but for every 15 you kill, you get an extra life, so I'm just going to try and kill as many as I can just for the hell of it.
We have one donation from Kipples_ for giving $85.67. It says Weebs out.
Now we're coming up on the second part of this mission, which is the final part. You have to destroy 4 turrets and then go inside the Skyhook and destroy the power core. So we'll see how I go. inside the ship. Hopefully I don't mess this up. A bit safe so I can get these shots off. And I've missed, so I'm gonna have to reload the missiles anyway. Can't remember which one I missed. Oh. That's this side here. And time's coming up in a few seconds, hopefully. Not yet. Those missiles didn't hit, so I have to quickly fly back in and hit the power core one more time. And time. So that was Shadows of the Empire. Hope you enjoyed it. It's a pretty fun game to play, I think. I'd recommend you give it a shot. It does have a PC version that is much faster as well. But you can't do all the glitches. So yeah, thank you for watching.